I'm Gage Crump. I'm an associate professor of stem cell biology and regenerative medicine.
Hi, I'm Francesca Mariani. I'm an assistant professor at USC's Stem Cell Research Center.
My name is Dr. Jay Lieberman. I'm professor of chairman of the Department of Orthopaedic Surgery at the Keck School of Medicine of USC. We've had an excellent collaboration between Drs. Crump, Mariani, and myself, and it was really initiated by the Regenerative Medicine Initiative. And this allowed us to apply for a grant where each of our laboratories receive funds to work together in a collaborative fashion to try to answer some questions related to bone repair and regeneration.
In my lab, we use zebrafish to understand how the skeleton can regenerate. And so zebrafish is a very attractive system to study regeneration because as adults, they have this wonderful ability to regenerate. They can repair 20% of missing heart. They can repair a fully severed spinal cord. And we found that they can repair up to half their jawbone when we remove it as adults.
I'm a geneticist, a mammalian biologist, and to partner with a basic biologist who studies zebrafish has been really wonderful. We could learn a lot about regeneration from looking at jaw resections in the zebrafish. We could then apply what was learned in the zebrafish system to look at what's happening in large-scale repair in the mouse. Then, with the help of Jay Lieberman's group, we could then apply some of the things that we found in our model systems to a more clinically relevant model that was developed by his laboratory.
I was treating patients with large bone defects associated with revision, total hip and knee replacement, and we didn't have a satisfactory solution. So I thought that we needed to develop animal models that related to bone regeneration and repair to try to answer those questions. Another group that we've seen more recently in the past decade are soldiers who unfortunately sustained high energy injuries from explosive devices or gunshot wounds where they've lost a lot of soft tissue and bone. And our hope with our research is to develop solutions for these problems.
So I think having this sort of collaboration makes you know, both clinicians and basic researchers kind of step out of their usual routine and just take and try to think of you know, what are the applied uses of the basic research findings. And so I think by coming together that moves things quicker ahead because the basic researchers can kind of focus on things that may be more useful in the clinic.
One of the most important findings is the discovery that cartilage is very, very important for mediating large-scale repair. And the kind of cartilage that's forming is a special kind of cartilage that has properties both of bone and cartilage. And that cartilage may, in fact, be a really important precursor to forming new bone. The collaboration has resulted in the first publication, which came out recently in development. In addition, we have used the preliminary data from the RMI grant to submit grants to the NIH. And fortunately, this has resulted in a very nice grant, an R01 grant. The grant amount is about $2.4 million, so we're looking forward to working on this in more detail in the next few years.